success has been working, only turned the ball over two times in the last three games on the road. We had seven penalties for 50 yards. We rushed for 230-something yards, outrushed our opponent 70 yards. That has been our formula for success on the road. To win on the road, especially in environments like this, you have to do those things. You can't have 5-yard penalties. You can't have turnovers in the red zone. You can't have turnovers for touchdowns. We talked about quarters coming in here. We talked about not being intimidated. I don't think I guys was intimidated. I looked at every one of them when they come off the field, look into the eyes, and our guys were not intimidated. We lost our poise at the end by 15-2 personal fouls. That cannot happen. It's not Kentucky football. Can't have dumb mistakes like that, like with the personal fouls. Can't have 5-yard penalties. Those are dumb mistakes. Those things have nothing to do with talent. And we had, that's about being poised with the environment, being poised with the play. Those are the things that cost you games in big games. We also talked about our special teams play. We gave up one big return. Kicker kicked it exactly where we wanted. We were playing a third of the field. We just didn't press the upfield shoulder, and he gets away from us. Again, cannot happen in big games. We allowed those things to happen in this game. Little things that'll cost you a game like this. We got to learn from it. Again, go on the road again next week. Those are the things that we got to get corrected. We can't turn the football, we can't have stupid penalties, and we can't give up big plays in any area, in any of the three areas. Any question?
Could you address Danny's situation, and did you think that had a negative effect on you defensively?
It's like an injury. In the Danny situation, he violated the team rule. We said it for a quarter, but it's like an injury. We expect the next guy to step up. But again, our players got to understand, can't be selfish and put yourself ahead of the football team also. Danny will learn from this, but we got to teach these kids more than football. There's no question about that. We got to teach them more than football, and this is a chance for us to teach Danny a lesson. He can't put himself in front of this football team. We also expect the next guy to step up.
Coach, on your defense, do you think you all got out-athleted at times, or did they just, it seemed like they were doing a lot of crossing, a lot of drag routes, and they were getting burdened on some of those?
I don't think we got out-athleted. We got out-leveraged. Okay, we were stopping our feet and looking in the backfield, those things. Those are things we cannot do against superior athletes. I mean, we got some superior athletes in the backfield also. But you can't stop your feet versus it. Stop your feet, get your eyes in the backfield when your eyes are supposed to be on your man. You just can't get out leverage. So I don't think they have superior. We got that athlete. I think we just got eyes in the wrong place, feet in the wrong place at the time.
I mean, were you surprised how much they, I mean, they had gone to him some, but not to that extent. It seemed like every time they
gone
to
Burton. Yeah, I mean, he did a really good job with the crossing routes and the wildcat package. Like I say, when he got out in open field, we got to run our feet. Okay, somebody asked me last week about Danny Trevathan's hand. Your hand has no bearing on your tackling. If you tackle with your feet and your face, okay, we're trying to run our feet and put our face on the ball. Therefore, your hands have no bearing. Okay. But if you leave your feet behind and leave your face behind, you don't miss tackles, and that's the thing that happened to us tonight.
Trouble, you came in here 3-0. I know your guys felt like they had a chance to win. The score is going to look like one of those typical Florida-Kentucky scores that people are going to have to win. Kind of thing. I understand. So how do you keep your team from feeling?
Well, I mean, it was. I mean, our guys fought. There's no question about it. We went toe-to-toe. If you look at the first half, it's a 21-7. And they had stole one in the first half. Interception for a touchdown. We let them sit down on us on the route, on the hitch route. We got to try to run past them, and we did with Chris Matthews in the second half. We can't cannot let him sit down. So it was a hard-fought game in the first half. And even in the second, we moved the ball, couldn't sustain drives. But defensively, we couldn't get ourselves off the football field in the second half.
About the running game?
Matthews,
Chris every week has gotten himself better. He's one of those guys that we had 29 practices in fall camp. He hasn't missed a practice in fall camp and a practice during the season. He continues to get himself better. He's making plays and making plays down the field. He's playing all-time high with his confidence. He's attacking the football. And that's what we expected out of him.
About the running game today?
Our running game? We had a chance to out-leverage them a couple of times, but their speed allows them to catch up. We didn't capture the perimeter as well as we had been. Got a couple of young tight ends that got tripped up. Didn't understand the speed of the game at times, but we did have a 100-yard rusher. Again, on the road, our games that we had been winning, those three games, we had rushed teams by 70 yards. You have to do that in order to win on the road. We didn't do it. They have rushed us today. But we did get our running game going at times. We did have a chance to increase them at times. Their speed gives them a chance to catch up a lot of plays. But we did block some plays clean. Blocked them to the safety. Got to make the safety miss and in their pursuit a couple times called us.
What's happening to you guys on these third and long situations? You're getting them third and six, third and nine, third and 13 in situations, and they're having some success there.
I'm sorry, say it again.
They're having some success on third and long. They did tonight. What's happening to
you guys in those situations? We are getting out of place. You know, we're in zone drops. You got to drop to your zones. Okay, you can't chase routes in zone. When we're in man coverage, you can't have your eyes in the backfield. You can't stop your feet. And a couple times that happened. Our zone drops. We're not dropping to our zone and then chasing routes. Or when you drop out of your zone, you give up a huge area. If you drop to your zone, then you chase a route, you give up a big area also. Those things can't happen. You got to get yourself off the field, third down, and you couldn't do it tonight.
What do you think you learned about your team? This was a pretty good litmus test at the competition level.
Yeah, you know, they won't get intimidated. We were not intimidated by the atmosphere. We weren't intimidated by how physical it was. Because there's a couple of times our backs lowered the shoulder and came out of the back end. Our tacklers at times ran through people. We just got to do it on a more consistent basis.
The fake field goal, is that something you saw on film? Something you had?
That's something that we have in our special team, special forces area. We always will carry it. Just something that you got to take a shot at it. Time to try it in another game, and they covered down on it. Today they did cover down on it, and we executed.
Like you say, it's 21-7 at the half. That kind of giving you a spark. You're in the game, then they take the second half kickoff and drive it right down and score.
Yeah.
That had to be a big momentum.
It was. We talked about that at halftime. We needed a three and out at that point in time. We needed our defense to go ahead and throw a shutout in the first series. That was the most important series because it was the next series. And we felt like we had gained some momentum. We've been able to score right before that.
What was your analysis of how Mike played?
Mike? I thought he played good. They popped a guy out on him in zone coverage that we turned the ball over in the red zone. And we've got to lay it off. When the guy gets that deep, he can't be greedy. You just got to drop the ball off. But he tried to stick one in there, and they picked it on the second interception for a touchdown. The guy set on us. And that's we've got to get people off of us by doing some double moves, by running past people, which we end up doing with Chris running past him on the one on our sideline, and then we ran a double move on the touchdown. Those are things we got to do. Probably need to do them a little bit earlier.
So the second one is as much on the receiver as it is on the
not the receiver. It's just the receiver's running what we tell him to do. He's running a 5-yard stop route. The guy set on him. Okay? We've got to do it. We've got to call some double moves to help both parties out.
So how do you kind of try to put this behind you and move? You got a big one next week on the road. How do you go about it?
this one, get our everything corrected, and then we've got it. Our goal is to win the East. I mean, it's not out of the question. We need some help. But this football team is a tough team, and like I said, they weren't intimidated by the atmosphere. They weren't intimidated by how physical it was. We'll be ready to go. We'll get them ready to go.